Hola, y'all. I don't have a lot of my voice, so when I try to speak kind of loudly, my voice goes out or it cracks. So you'll have to forgive me. And I don't think I turned on my porch light over here, so I'll have to turn this on as well. I just replaced this bulb. Happy Saturday? No, it's Friday. Right? Yeah, happy Friday. I'm going to jump right into it. I want to talk about, I'll tell you, we're going to read from 1 Kings chapter 20 and verse 4. And the king of Israel answered and said, "My Lord, O king, according to thy saying, I am thine and all that I have." Now, I want to give you a little context. This is Ahab, king of Israel. He was not a great king, but he was the king of Israel. There was another king, an enemy king, that I think was the king of Syria. And he basically, Ben-Hadad, he sends his servants to Ahab. And he says, "Tell Ahab that all of his silver and his gold and his stuff, it's all mine. It's mine." And Ahab says, "According to your saying, I am thine and all that I have." Ahab doesn't resist the king of Syria at all. He literally lets him say, "You can take all my stuff." As soon as the king of Israel says, "Okay, Ben-Hadad, king of Syria, you said you wanted it, you can have it all." Then the king of Syria says, "Oh, okay." And he sends a message and he said, "I'm going to come." First, he said he just wanted his silver and gold, I believe. And then the next message he sends is, "Oh, I'm going to come and I'm going to go through your house. And I'm going to take your wives and I'm going to go in your house and I'm going to look at all your stuff. And I'm going to take whatever I want of yours that belongs to you, I'm going to take it." Then Ahab is like, "Wait a minute. I didn't say you could come in and have that stuff." And I want to talk about that for a moment. So my thoughts on the scripture. The enemy declares what he's about to take in our lives. And we say to him helplessly, "Okay, you can have it." Then he gets bolder. And he goes for more. We give him an inch and he takes a mile. He has no power over us except what we allow. Why are we letting him in our houses to see our stuff and to name what he wants? He's not welcome into the camp. Stand up and say no. It really, I'm trying to clear my throat so I can talk louder. It really baffles me that Ahab, king of Israel, well, I know why he didn't have a backbone. He was an evil king. He didn't live right. He didn't follow God. Maybe if he obeyed and had a relationship with God, he would have known that he didn't have to be scared. But when an enemy king sends his servants and says to you, "I'm coming to take all your stuff. It's mine." My first response, your first response should not be, okay, take my stuff. No, that's not it. But that's what he did. And I think he thought, if I let him have some of this stuff, he'll be happy and he'll leave me alone. But immediately, Ben-Hadad, the king of Syria, realized he's weak. He let me come in and take his stuff. Well, then I'm going for more, and I'm going to go in for things that are super important to him, super personal. I'm not just going to take his money. I'm going to take his house. I'm going to take his wives. I'm going to go in and strip him of everything precious because he's not strong. He's weak. And the only reason why that enemy king decided he could do that was because the king of Israel, Ahab, did not even put up a fight. And so he knew, I got this. Application. How am I going to apply this? I'm going to anoint my home with oil today. I'm going to stand and say no. Now, I don't know if that's new to you. The Bible talks about anointing with oil a lot. It also talks about anointing the sick, praying for the sick, anointing cloths as an act of faith. So this is not something strange, but if you've never heard of this before, then I don't mind introducing it to you. You can anoint your doors of your homes, your windows, or just your home in any way you want to, and pray. Like, anoint it, literally take oil, put some oil on your thumb or your finger, touch your doorpost, and pray over your home that the enemy would not enter your home. Pray for your home, pray for your spouse, pray for your children. Pray over your home that nobody would be welcome in there. No spirit would be welcome in there. Plead the blood over your home and stand up and say no. The enemy's not allowed in your house. He's not allowed in your marriage. He's not allowed in your children. He's not allowed. Stand up and say no. He's going to try to come to you and say, your husband is mine. Your wife is mine. Your children are mine. Your job is mine. Your finances are mine. Your wealth is mine. Your health is mine. I'm going to take it. He's going to try to come into your life just like Ben-Hadad, the king of Syria. He's trying to come in, and he's going to walk in boldly like a lion, like a roaring lion. He's going to walk in, and he's just going to start claiming stuff, and he's going to say, that's mine, that's mine, I'm taking that, that's mine. And he's going to try to intimidate you and make you feel like you have no power, to make you feel like he's going to take it and that you can't stop him. But that's a lie. It's a bluff. And he's hoping that you just willingly let these things go. He's hoping that you don't fight, because he knows that you're more powerful than he is. So he's got to make himself big when he shows up the first time, so that you will be like King Ahab and be scared to say no. And you think, oh, if I just give him this, he'll leave me alone. He won't touch my most precious items. If I just give him what he wants the first time, if I just give him the riches, then he won't mess with my children. If I just give him this, then he won't touch my spouse. If I just give him this part of my heart, he won't touch. And it's a lie. He's coming, and he's not going to quit coming until you stand up and say no. He's not interested in just taking a little and leaving you alone. He wants to come in and take over all and devour. The Bible says he is like a roaring lion walking around seeking whom he may devour. He's here to destroy. He's here to devour. So no, he's not happy with the inch. He's going to start with an inch, and then he's going to take a mile. Connecting scripture, Psalm 44, 5. Oh, I didn't finish my application. I'm not going to allow him into my home, and he doesn't get my mind either. Now, connecting scripture, Psalm 44 and 5. Through thee will we push down our enemies. Through thy name will we tread them under that rise up against us. We have victory in Jesus' name. And that's why I said, pray over your home, pray over your family, pray over your marriage, your job, your finances, and your kids. These things are not up for sale. These things are not up for the enemy to take and to strip. They are not up for debate. You go and pray in your home over these people, over these things. These are yours. These are God's. We belong to God. The enemy doesn't have a right to come and pluck anybody or anything out of God's hands. And we don't allow him to. Kingdom. How does this relate? God is fighting for us, and he's fighting with us. And we need to stand and fight with our brothers and our sisters in the kingdom. Pray for each other and encourage each other. The enemy is out here to seek, to kill, and destroy everybody. Not just me, not just you. He's after us all. We all have a bounty on our head. And like I said, he's going around and he's looking for weak spots in our lives. He's looking for weak spots in our family. He's going to look for that weak spot that's in your home and your children. He's going to look for the weak spot in your finances, at your job. He's going to look for the weak spots in your church. He's looking for weakness. And then he's going to march in your mind, or he's going to use a person or a situation, and he's going to demand things. He does it in a lot of different ways, but he's trying to bring intimidation and fear, because he doesn't want you to realize that you are stronger than he is, and that the power of God inside of you, he can't do anything. But if he can make you doubt it and make you not take it to the Lord, and just cower down and say, okay, you can have this, just leave me alone. You can have this, just go away. You can have this, I don't want to fight. Just don't take everything, just take some of it. But I'm here to tell you today, he doesn't operate that way. He's not here to take a piece. He's here to take it all. And we cannot allow him one moment in our lives. We cannot allow him one inch. We cannot allow him one doorway, one window. You cannot allow any place. Give no place to the devil. He doesn't deserve to be in the same place as you, as me, as the Lord. And don't think that you can befriend him, King Ahab to King Syria. You're not friends. He's there to spy and to see what he can take. And he's not going to quit until he takes it all. So this is not a friendship. You're not making an alliance with the enemy. You're not going to make any deals. You don't make deals with the devil and win. That's not how this works. But you are stronger with God. We both are stronger than that. I'm not giving him any place. He's not welcome in my life. He's not welcome in my life. He's not welcome in my family. He's not welcome in my home. And no, I'm not giving him my stuff. And I'm not giving him my people. And I'm not giving him my mind or my emotions. And I refuse, and you do too, to be intimidated. To be made to be intimidated or scared. I'm not scared. I'm not intimidated. I know who I serve. I know whose spirit I have. And he's nothing. He is nothing. Be strong. Be courageous. We got this. God's got this. I know who wins. I've read the back of the book. And we do. No matter what the weapon is, no weapon formed against us shall prosper. And no devil is walking in my life or in my home and claiming anything that belongs to me. Not today, Satan. Not ever. See you tomorrow.
The weapon may be formed, but it won't prosper. When the darkness falls, it won't prevail. 'Cause the God I serve knows only how to triumph.